Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this fast track lecture series which has been brought to you by EduTap. So see, in this particular fast track lecture series we are going to cover your ESI and finance current affairs, which are important if you are preparing for RBI grade B, NABARD grade A or SEBI grade A of 2019. So this particular video is about lecture 52 and we are going to cover March 8th to 14th in this particular lecture. So, telling you about our previous results, you can see here that in 2017, 27 of our students got selected in RBI Grade B. And this year, more than 70 of our students have been selected. Similarly, NABARD Grade A, in 2017, there were 11 selections. And this year, we have got 26 selections from our students. And the SEBI Grade A of 2018, more than 150 of our students have got the interview call. So, here also, we are expecting the brilliant result. Now let me tell you about our courses which are being offered by us. You can choose from any of these courses as per your requirement, as per the exam you are preparing. And we have the combo courses as well. If you are preparing for two or more exams simultaneously, then you can go for these combo courses. Like if you are preparing for RBI NABARD, you can choose this course. And we have the different combo courses as per your requirement, you can choose from them. And here is the good news for you guys. We have come up with a new course called as QREs, that is Quantitative Aptitude, Reasoning Ability and English. So this is important for your banking examinations and you can go for this course also. So now let us go back to your lecture of the day and let us see what is your first news starting from March 8th. So this news is about a very important portal which we had covered earlier also, psblonesin59minutes.com. So that was the loan, that was about the loan to the MSMEs by PSBs in 59 minutes. So that this portal was in news earlier, but now why is in news again? See, there has been a report by Credit Suisse, the global financial firm, and they say that this web portal, PSB Loans in 59 Minutes, has emerged as India's largest online lending platform. So that means, according to the report, it says the loans of more than rupees 35,000 crore have been sanctioned in this through this platform. So that is a very important thing, and that makes this PSB loans more important because at the international level through the global firms it is also being recognized. So actually the portal was launched last year in 2018 and it provides the credit line up to rupees 1 crore to MSMEs in just 59 minutes. So that is about the reduction in the turnaround time. So that means earlier the entire process used to take 20 to 25 days, but now since through this portal the process has become online transparent, so now it takes only 59 minutes to grant the loan. So this is very important. And you can read about the features of the portal, although we had covered earlier also when it was launched, but now you can see here that the majority stake in the portal is of SIDBI, and there are also the 5 PSPs. So you have to keep in mind the name of these 5 PSPs. So digital platform for MSME financing, the keyword for you here, that not all the loans, only MSMEs up to a limit of 1 crore. So a kind of interface this loan, this particular portal is providing, and also the bankers can create loan products in line with the different models. So these are some portal features, you can go through them, and the relevance I have already discussed with you. So moving to your next news. National Annual Rural Sanitation Survey, so NARSS, it was conducted by Independent Verification Agency and the World Bank has come up with this National Annual Rural Sanitation Survey. So this survey is important, you see, because Swachh Bharat Mission is running and 2014 to 2019 was our target. These 5 years we had come when it was launched to set up a clean India, open defecation free India. So now this rural sanitation survey says that 96.5% of the households who have the access to toilets actually use it. So do you see that earlier it was being speculated that probably there are the toilets which are being built under this mission, Grameen component of Swachh Bharat Mission. There are two sub-components of SBM, Grameen and Urban, but probably people are not using the toilets. So that is was being considered, but now this international survey supported by World Bank has confirmed that no, people are using it, and thus the open defecation status, open defecation free status is reconfirmed. So that is a very important news for us. And there are certain findings of this survey also, you can just read them. The survey says that 93.1% of the households have the access to toilets, and 96.5% of the people actually use them, and also 90.7% of villages have been reconfirmed to get the ODF status. So all in all, the findings are very much satisfying, and these are important. I am not going to cover Swachh Bharat Mission in detail here. We have covered it multiple times, and you have to know about Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen and Urban also. Okay, so we are done with this news. So World Wildlife Day, this is important because I will tell you. First, let us see what this news is about. So March 3rd was celebrated as this World Wildlife Day. Okay, so this news of March 3rd, I'm sorry, it is we are a bit late in this particular, it should have been in a previous video, but anyhow, let us see what is this about. The theme is important. It is being celebrated at the global level, life below water for people and planet. Are you guys able to recall the SDGs, 17 SDGs we had covered? That you must know. And life below water, this is related to directly to your SDG 14. That is why it becomes important. And moreover, the CITES treaty is also very important for us. And the CITES, on the day when it was adopted, is celebrated as World Wildlife Day, that is March 3rd. So CITES is actually a treaty, that is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wildlife and of Flora and Fauna. So this is the treaty which was actually signed on 3rd March. The day is being celebrated as World Wildlife Day, and let me tell you that the theme of this year is directly related to your SDG 14, and that is why we are covering it here. Okay, and again, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is in news. So Swachh Sarvekshan 2019 awards have been released. So earlier, SBM Grameen component, we had seen the National Rural Sanitation Survey. So Swachh Sarvekshan 2019 is about Swachh Bharat Urban Mission. So the survey of 2019 says that the cleanest city in the country is Indore. So Indore has come up as the cleanest city, which is followed by Bhopal has been declared as the cleanest capital. So there were categories actually: cleanest capital, cleanest city, then population category cities were also divided. So Indore is the cleanest city, which is followed by Ambikapur in Chhattisgarh and Mysore in Karnataka, whereas the capital which is cleanest is Bhopal. Okay, don't get confused here. This go through it properly. And Ujjain has also bagged the cleanest city award in the medium category, medium population, that is 3 lakh to 10 lakh, because when the population is more than 10 lakh, the city is considered of the large population it has. So that was it about it. So let us see what is this. Okay. So RBI has notified the interest subsidy scheme for the short term crop loans. So Reserve Bank of India has recently notified that they are going to provide the interest subvention for short term crop loans of 2% for the year 2018-19 to 2019-20. So this has been notified, and it has also been approved by the center. So keep this in mind that short term crop loans, it is going to be 2%, and this scheme says that the farmers who are repaying their loans promptly, they would be given interest subvention of additional 2%. So all in all, 4% for the farmers who are repaying their loans promptly. Otherwise, it is 2%. Initially, it is 2%. Later on, if you are promptly paying your loans, then you are going to get 4% subsidy. It is important, keep in mind the date would be the actual repayment of the crop loan would be considered. Okay, so another important news by RBI has issued guidelines related to your white label ATMs. So as you know, there are two types of ATMs. Broadly we say white label and brown label ATMs. So the ATMs which are not managed by the bank, though the service is provided by some other entity, are called as the white label ATM. So RBI has issued new guidelines, so it becomes important for us. RBI has allowed companies that manage these machines to source with this cash directly from RBI. So earlier they were these white label ATMs who were managing them, they were not allowed to go to RBI. They had to go to the intermediary bank in between. But now they can directly go to RBI. So white label ATM operators, they can go to RBI and get their currency chest filled, and they are also allowed to source currency from any other scheduled bank. Okay, then operators, okay, I think this point is repeated here. It is about, yes, this point is repeated here. I'm sorry about that. So anyways, next point is that white label ATM operators, there can all, they also they are allowed to offer the bill payments and deposit services. So these are the guidelines which have been now formed, and also they would be able to display the advertisements on the their ATM machines, so that is going to be a source for their revenue generation. So these are such things which were not provided to WLAs, but now with these guidelines they are eligible for these ATMs. White label ATM operators also are eligible for this. So go through this slide properly. Okay. So this news is about the signing of agreement between the IFC, that is International Finance Corporation, with IBBI. So IBBI is our Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India, and a cooperation agreement has been signed with IFC, a member of the World Bank Group. So first of all, you have to know the five members of World Bank Group. Do let me know about the five members. You some of you have already mentioned it. I asked this question earlier also, and you guys came up with the answer. I hope now you all know it. And this news says that IBBI has signed this agreement with IFC. In this particular agreement, IFC is going to train the professionals and agencies about the for the purpose of the code. So basically the training purpose is the going to be effected under particular this cooperation agreement. So till 2021, IFC is going to train IBBI and professionals and professional agencies also. So various assistances would be provided. You can just go through it and see. First of all, let me tell you, IFC is important and IBBI is also very important for you. Insolvency Bankruptcy Board of India. In 2016, Insolvency Bankruptcy Code was passed, and then this board was set up so as to particularly set up and operate that code. So for that purpose only this now important agreement has been signed. So these are some very important news. I would recommend you guys to brush up your static portion also of the syllabus along with current affairs. Okay, so this is your last news. India has been ranked at 11th position in the gold holding. So World Gold Council has come up with a report in which India has, according to the report, India has the gold holding of the 11th position in the world. Let me tell you that India is the largest consumer of the gold. Being the consumer of the gold, also the gold holding is not that much. In among the Asian countries, China and Japan have more reserves than India. So you can see here that it has been topped, the gold reserves have been topped by US, followed by Germany. IMF, the International Monetary Fund, at the third position, and you can see here India at the 11th position. So these are the top 15 rankers under this World Gold Council's index. So if you want to know about World Gold Council, I have mentioned it here. It is a market development organization for the gold industry, headquartered in UK, but has various other offices, which includes India also. And it works across all the parts of industries and whatever are related to the gold. That means gold mining, investment, and basically the Gold Council wants to sustain the demand for gold, the precious metal. So and that is it. Keep this in mind about World Gold Council, India's position, and how is it? You should know that if we have the reserves of gold, that are actually considered very important for any country, and that stabilizes your currency also. Okay, so there is another news. India Cooling Action Plan has been launched. So India has it has become one of the first countries to come up with a cooling action plan. So it was recently launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, and there are certain targets which have been set up under this cooling action plan. Now these targets are important. Let us see. So the plan says that cooling demand across these sectors has to be reduced by 20 to 25%. Then refrigerant demand has again to be reduced. The year which has been set up is 2037 to 2038. So we have around 18 years to work on this. Then cooling energy requirements also to be reduced. Then recognizing the cooling and related areas. These are some of the targets. I would recommend you to just keep in mind these numbers and what is this plan all related to. We'll be done with this anyways. It is related to your, again, your sustainable development, again SDGs, because India also wants to attain the targets set up under these SDGs, and environment, sustainable development is actually a part of that. So it is a step under that only. So now we are done with your ESI as well as finance news. So let us try to solve your MCQs. I would recommend you guys to pause the video for 10 seconds. Try to solve the questions. So which of the following has the maximum stake in the lending portal PSB loans in 59minutes.com? See, although the answer was the SIDBI and five major banks were asked, but we are going to answer it as SIDBI, because we had seen that SIDBI along with five banks were there. So these have equal proportion, PNB, SBI. But our answer is, in this question, it would be SIDBI. You anyways have to know the five name of the banks also. Question 2. Recently, National Annual Rural Sanitation Survey has been released. According to it, how much percentage of households have access to the toilets? So this is an important question. Access to toilets is being asked here. So 93.1% people have access to toilets, while 96.5% of the people actually use them when they have it. And Bank of India in the index of gold holding as released by World Gold Council. So this year it is asking, 2019. So the answer is option C, that is position is 11th. How much percentage of interest subsidy has been notified by RBI for the short-term crop loans? This is also important. So our answer is 2%. But it was also notified that for the prompt repairs, it is going to be later 4%. But anyhow, our answer is 2. And here are your solutions. So that's it guys, we are done with your this lecture number 52. In case you guys have any query related to the courses or exams, you can just drop us a mail at hello@edutap.co.in. You can also call us or even WhatsApp us at 8146207241, and you can visit our website www.edutap.co.in. Thank you for watching this video guys. I wish you all a very happy learning from the team EduTap, and keep learning. See you in the next video.